Greetings and salutations. It's good to be with you once again on this balmy winter's day in February. I welcome you with all my heart. This is satsang. It is here that you meet yourself. Yourself that you really are. Effortless pure awareness. You are infinite like the sky. There is nothing in this world or anywhere else that can affect you or cause harm to come to you. Unless you believe it. There is something more beautiful, more grand, more wonderful than you can ever imagine. It exists within you. Which is the substratum of all existence. Yet, in order to feel this joy, this bliss, in order to find this total freedom from life's so-called burdens, you have to dig for yourself. You have to give up something. You can't stay the way you are with the same disposition, the same values, the same preconceived ideas, the same concepts, and be free. You can't do this. You have to do an about face and totally give up all of your ideas about life. Totally surrender your ego, your mind, your body, your preconceived ideas. You have to want it yourself. And when you want it bad enough, something will happen to you. When you desire liberation, more than anything else in life, this means you have begun to give up the rest of your stuff that we talked about. That's the only way to desire liberation. This is a legitimate desire. Because you're not really asking for something. You are giving up the stuff you don't need anymore. Your anger, your pettiness, your bad disposition, your temper, your greed, all of the things that you've carried around for so long. This is how you desire liberation. By speaking to the Lord within you, the total surrender. Lord, take my anger. Take my greed. take my bad disposition, take my temper. And you give it up totally. Once you do this, automatically, you are liberated. Compassion means reverence for all of life. Everything is alive. There's no such thing as dead matter. Everything has its own life. When you have reverence for life, you respect everything. You have no animosity towards anyone or anything. I'm not only talking about human beings. I'm speaking of the mineral kingdom, the vegetable kingdom, the animal kingdom, the human kingdom. Have you ever heard of a sage or a liberated person who was at odds with anything in this world? You have to come to terms with yourself. Too many Advaita Vedantins, non-duality people, always go around shouting, I am one with this, I am one with that, everything is absolute reality. And yet they have so many bad habits. It's sort of paradoxical. Many times I tell you everything is karmic, everything is pure identity. Everything that's happened to you is pure identity. You cannot lift one finger. There's nothing pure identity for you to do so. Yet in the same time I'm telling you that you have to give up certain things and develop higher qualities, which is right. Well, you would say to yourself, if everything is pure then, why should I care about what I do, how I act, and how I live? Everything is supposed to happen anyway. This is true on one level. But then again, you have the total freedom to turn within and not to react to life situations. You have that freedom. So everything is pure identity, but at the same time, you have the freedom to turn within and find out to whom pure alienation comes from. By lifting yourself up, into a higher state of consciousness, and becoming free. Compassion is very important. Think of the times in your life that you couldn't have compassion within, or your thoughts interfered, you came to a conclusion based on the thoughts that came through your head. For instance, you see a homeless person who asks you for a couple of dollars or whatever. It makes no difference why he wants a couple of dollars. When he wants to buy some whiskey, when he wants to buy bread, what he wants to do. It is your duty to help anyone who comes into your atmosphere. Anyone who comes into your life must be helped. It is no accident that this homeless person came to you. Do not turn him away. For by turning him away, you're turning yourself away. This is compassion. Reconciling yourself with the whole universe, all of the kingdoms. We should have a great compassion for every animal on this earth. Whether they're ants or cockroaches, or goats or sheep or cows. If we had a compassion like this, would we eat meat? We have to have a great compassion for all the flowers, vegetation, everything that exists. We have to have a great compassion for all the minerals on this earth, everything. This is reconciling ourselves with the entire universe. This is important. Some of us wonder why we've been on this path for a long time and we don't seem to make too much progress. It's because your compassion is not big enough.